This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Srinivasan. It has been 6 months since a Deepwater Horizon spill really began. We are joined on the phone and on the through the magic of the internet with Bob Marshall, who's a reporter from the Times-Picayune. Thanks for being with us today.
Pleasure.
Now, you've been covering this for quite some time now. When we have the sort of advantage of hindsight, looking at the big picture in 6 months, what are the big differences that you're seeing?
Well, there's the big difference is that the fear of this big black tsunami of oil washing ashore, the worst case scenario never really happened, and so that was one bullet we dodged. But the questions that began immediately is what would the long-term impact of this be when the oil stopped? That still is there, so nothing's really changed there. And oil still is coming ashore in bits and pieces every now and then. In fact, today, just in the last hour or so, we've gotten reports of a pretty good size chunk, as they would call it, or strips of oil coming into West Bay. We're sending out a photographer to get some pictures and chase that story down. But overall, no one knows what the long-term impacts will be.
So when we think about the environmental consequences, it seems that if the oil is still coming in small waves or stretches, as you describe them, there's still no way to tell exactly what the impact is going to be on the fisheries or the fish that are out there, the crabs that are out there.
That's exactly right. And you know, some state officials made that forecast about a month into this. The head of the Department of Wildlife and Fisheries said that, you know, his best guess would be that there'll be, you know, pieces and strips of oil coming in for months, if not years, and that would be fighting these small battles along the coast, possibly for years to come.
Let's talk a little bit about the economic impact. What was it? There's a term down there called the spillionaires. Some fishermen that are getting paid fairly handsomely at the moment.
Yeah. Now this isn't all fishermen, but it's a sizable number. Charter boat skippers and commercial fishermen with captain's licenses who have hired out to BP and the Vessels of Opportunity program to do cleanup work are getting $1,500 a day. And as I understand it, they can still file a claim for lost businesses. So among themselves, the joke has been that they've become spillionaires. Some of these men have worked, 2.5 months without a day off, and so they've accumulated quite a bit of money, but that doesn't mean they're not worried about the future.
Because these payments will stop.
Yeah, eventually, and they're beginning to stop now. These people will be laid off, and their concern is who will want to fish here if you're a charter boat captain. Who'll want to book a trip if there's some concern about whether the fish are safe to eat? If you're a commercial fisherman, and a year from now, researchers show up with oil and oysters or shrimp from Louisiana and no one's buying your catch, then you may not have enough money to survive. Basically, they want to continue to fish. They're happy for the money they're getting now, but they're nervous about the future.
And I should reemphasize that distinction that it's not all fishermen, really. It's kind of even there, it's the top of the totem pole there. The folks that might be the deckhands aren't seeing this kind of windfall.
The deckhands aren't. It's the captains of the boat, the guys with the licenses, and people who might work at a shrimp dock or picking crabs at a crab shack, they're not getting this money. They're just out of work.
All right. Bob Marshall from the Times-Picayune, thanks so much for your reporting, and thanks for joining us.
My pleasure.
This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Srinivasan. Stay with us.